Hi, and welcome to the 8th part of the Simple Character Controller series. In the previous one we made a simple camera follow script, and in this one we will make the camera rotate or orbit around the player. We will also update the player controller for camera relative movement, so let's get started. In Unity, open up the input actions again. We need a new action called Look. Set the action type to pass through, the control type to Vector2, and for its binding, choose mouse and delta. Don't forget to save your asset. For this episode, we are just going to modify our previous camera manager script, so go ahead and open that up. Let's start by typing using UnityEngine.InputSystem in the top here. Now, right below our awake method, let's create a new one. Public void look, and as for the parameter, type input_action.callbackContext followed by context. Create a new variable of type vector2 called input, and inside of our newly created method, type input equals context.readValue, and within angle brackets, vector2, ending with opening and closing parentheses. Now, every time we move our mouse, the input value gets updated. At the bottom here, below everything else, let's create a new struct. Type public struct mouse sensitivity, finishing up with curly brackets. Inside of this struct, type public float horizontal and public float vertical. Type serializable within square brackets right above it and scroll back up to your variables. Now we can type serialize field within square brackets, followed by private mouse sensitivity, and just call it mouse sensitivity. I'm doing this instead of having two separate floats here, one for mouse sensitivity X and one for mouse sensitivity Y. Perhaps a personal preference, but I find this cleaner, both in code but also in the inspector, where we will set the values in a minute. Let's scroll down again and create another struct, public struct camera rotation. And within it, type public float pitch and public float yaw. Let's look at this simple illustration. Pitch is the rotation of the camera on the x-axis, and yaw is the y-axis. We won't be rolling our camera, so we can just ignore that one. This one doesn't need to be serialized, but scroll up again and here, type private camera rotation and call it camera rotation. Now, add an update method and type camera rotation.yaw plus equals input.x, which is the x value we get from the mouse delta up here, multiplied by mouse sensitivity.horizontal, which you find here, multiplied by time.delta time. The x value means we're moving the mouse left and right, and with this we can rotate the camera on the y-axis. Continue with camera rotation.pitch plus equals input.y, multiplied by mouse sensitivity.vertical, multiplied by time.delta time. Again, the y value means we're moving the mouse up and down, meaning we're rotating the camera on the x-axis. Now, we're going to want to clamp the vertical rotation of the camera, so let's, down here, create a new struct called camera angle with two public floats, min and max. Make this one serializable as well, as we did for mouse sensitivity up here. Scroll up and add a new variable, private camera angle, and call it camera angle. And make the field serialized. Now, back in our update method, we can type camera rotation.pitch equals mathf.clamp with camera rotation.pitch as the first argument, followed by camera angle.min and camera angle.max. Here, we are clamping the pitch value, meaning it cannot be less than the min value, nor can it be higher than the max value. Let's rename this offset variable and call it distance to player instead. Also, make it a float. Now we can set this in the awake method instead of offset by typing distance to player equals vector3.distance, where the first parameter is transform.position and the second one is target.position. This will give us the distance between the camera and the player as a float, which is perfect in case you ever want to add functionality for zooming in and out. Clear the entirety of the late update method and type transform.EulerAngles equals new vector 3 with camera rotation.pitch as the first argument, camera rotation.yaw as the second, and 0 as the third. This will rotate the camera, and to set the position, you can type transform.position equals target.position minus transform.forward multiplied by distance to player. Let's now have a look at our variables, and we can probably clean this up a bit. We are no longer using the smooth time, nor the current velocity, so it makes no sense for us to keep them here. Let's quickly try everything in Unity, to make sure everything up to now is working. First, choose player input in the hierarchy. Choose events and gameplay, and find your new look event here. Click on the plus symbol, and drag your camera into the object field. For its function, choose Camera Manager and up here, choose Look. Now, select your camera object and let's set some values in the Camera Manager. What I think plays well might not be to your taste, so I'm leaving you to find the perfect values for your game, and preferably allow the player to modify some, such as the mouse sensitivity. But I'll set my mouse sensitivity to 20 for both vertical as well as horizontal, and the camera angle to min 10 and max 50. And let's finally try this out! You might now notice that the player doesn't rotate as we are rotating the camera. Preferably with like camera relative movement, meaning we can press the W key to move forward and use the mouse to rotate our player. But we should still be able to press A to walk towards the camera. What's good for us is that this isn't too difficult to accomplish, so open up the player controller script again. We need a reference to the camera, so let's add one here, private camera, and call it main camera. In the awake method, type main camera equals camera.main. Scroll back up and rename smooth time to rotation speed. You can update the value to something else, say 500. In the apply rotation method, remove both target angle and angle, and we won't set the rotation yet, so remove it as well. Now, let's modify our direction variable here. Direction equals quaternion.euler with 0 as the first parameter, maincamera.transform.eulerangles.y as the second, and 0 as the third. We are multiplying this with new vector 3, where the first parameter is input.x, the second one 0, and the third one input.y. Now, type var target rotation equals quaternion.lookRotation, where the first parameter is direction and the second one is vector3.up. And finally, let's set the rotation by typing transform.rotation equals quaternion.rotateTowards, where the first parameter is transform.rotation, the second one is target rotation, and the third one is rotation speed multiplied by time.deltaTime. Now, in the update method, move the apply rotation call first, above apply gravity. And before we're done here, let's just check if we can clean this up a bit. Scroll up and remove current velocity, since we're not using that one anymore. Let's jump back into Unity now to test this out. Hit play and move your character. If you now hold down W to move forward and move your mouse, you can see that the character rotates at the same time, relative to the camera's rotation. We could also add an option to invert the mouse. Open up the Camera Manager script again. A quick way to invert the rotation on any axis would be to negate the rotation value. Let's look at the horizontal value here as an example. If we multiply input.x with a negative horizontal value, the rotation will be inverted. However, we could have this as an option in the inspector and later as a choice for the player. Let's first, down in mouse sensitivity, type public bool invert vertical and public bool invert horizontal. Now, to get a value out of this, we could here, below the late update method, create a new static method with an integer as its return value. Private static int bool to int, bool be within the parentheses, that returns 1 if true and a negative 1 if not. To keep this short, what this does is it grabs a boolean passed as an argument, and if the value is true, we return 1, otherwise we just return a negative 1. The way we're going to use this is by multiplying the mouse sensitivity values here. Mouse sensitivity.horizontal multiplied by bool to int with mouse sensitivity dot invert horizontal within the parentheses. And the same for vertical, but with the invert vertical boolean. Now we can jump back into Unity to make sure this is working. If you look at the camera manager component, you can see your new options to invert the camera rotation. Hit play and test it out. And there you have it, everything seems to be working. Remember that you can, and should, fine-tune these values to make sure that it feels good for your game. And if you have any questions, let me know down in the comments section. The code is updated on my GitHub page, and you can find the link down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.